In this example, we will look at polymerization carried out in a continuous stir tank reactor. And what we want to do is calculate molecular weight distribution, the moments, which we'll explain, the degree of polymerization, the average molecular weights, and the poly dispersity, which is related to the spread in the distribution. We're going to do this for a simplified addition polymerization in order to make the calculations easier to see what's happening. We're given the feed concentration into Cstr. We're given the initiation rate constant and the propagation rate constant. And there won't be any termination steps. Again, to simplify the calculation, we'll assume this is a living polymerization that it'll continue to grow as we run for longer times. So we'll need two other pieces of information. First, we're going to do the general setup of the problem, and then we're going to look at the case for a residence time. A tau. So we're going to use the residence time, or tau, of 500 seconds, and we're going to use the molecular weight of the monomer as 45. The calculation I'm going to do will probably be split into two videos to make them easier to watch. In the first one, we'll go through the mass balance to set up the problem. So here's a representation of a CSTR, and the notation is that the inlet concentration is M0. That's for the monomer. Some of the monomer reacts, so the exit monomer concentration is lower. Again, M here represents the exit concentration. Of course, also represents the concentration in the CSTR because it's a well-mixed system. And then PI represents the concentration of the polymer that has I monomer units. So P1 means it has one monomer unit, and this is the initiation step. And then P2 is P1 plus M to make a two monomer polymer. Now the reactions that we're looking at is initiation step, in which the monomer becomes active. And then P1, I mean this polymer, is reactive, so that it can react with a monomer unit to make P2. P2 can react with a monomer unit to make P3, and in general, PJ can react with a monomer unit to make EJ plus 1. I'll change this PJ just so we won't get it confused with initiation. The rate for the propagation steps is the rate constant for propagation, the concentration of the polymer, and the concentration of the monomer, like an elementary step. We have the rate constant for propagation. We have the rate constant for initiation. So now we're going to do the mass balances for the monomer and the polymer. Steady state system. So it's a steady state CSTR, which means accumulation term is zero. V0 is the volumetric flow rate into reactor. M0 is the inlet monomer concentration. And the volumetric flow rate out, we're assuming, is going to be the same. Again, a simplifying assumption. And the monomer concentration will be lower. When we're writing this balance, we'll write first the rate that monomer reacts times the volume. The rate that the monomer reacts, and I'll put the negative sign here because monomer is disappearing, and I'll just put the negative sign here rather than writing on the right side negative sign. So in this first step, monomer reacts in first order reaction initiation step, and then in every one of these steps, monomer reacts. So that means we have the propagation times the monomer concentration times all of the polymer concentrations. So that means the sum from J equals 1 to infinity of each of these polymer concentrations, because each of these steps will react away the monomer. And we can substitute this rate expression into our mass balance, and then we'll simplify by using tau, which we're given, which is the volume over the volumetric flow rate for the reactor. So if we do that, our mass balance for the monomer becomes M0 minus M minus monomer reacting by initiation step, and then monomer reacting by each of the propagation steps, the sum over J, and it means from J equals 1 to infinity of Pj. So that's our mass balance for the monomer. We now need mass balance for the polymers if we're going to calculate a molecular weight distribution. So let's look at first the simplest case, polymer 1. We're writing a mass balance. There's no accumulation because it's steady state. There's no polymer flowing into reactor, so our flow term in is 0. Flow term out, volumetric flow rate times the concentration of polymer 1. And then we need a rate expression for how fast polymer 1 reacts. We simplify this, again using tau. So this becomes minus polymer 1. Now we need the rate expression. So polymer 1's involved in two steps. It forms in this first step, and it reacts in this second step. So we need those two steps in our mass balance. The fact that it's forming means it's a positive term. First order monomer concentration, and then the resonance time. And then the propagation step, we're using up P1, so M times P1 times tau. And we can do the algebra to rearrange this. And doing this rearrangement, we have polymer 1 concentration in terms of the initiation rate constant, the monomer concentration in the reactor, tau, this propagation rate constant, and again, the monomer concentration in the reactor. Now we do the same thing for polymer 2, and for polymer 2, of course, the situation is different. There's different reaction steps. So in polymer 2, we form polymer 2 in this step, and we use it up in this step. So there's two propagation steps in which polymer 2 is involved. Again, steady state, so accumulation is 0. There's no polymer 2 flowing in. There's polymer 2 leaving. We form, so that's a positive sign here, propagation, monomer concentration. We form polymer 2 from polymer 1 by a reactor. And then we react polymer 2 with a monomer. So polymer 2 reacting, the rate's proportional to its concentration, and it reacts to make polymer 3. So that means we can, again, rearrange this and use tau. We have an expression for polymer 2 concentration in terms of, in this case, polymer 1, the monomer concentration, resonance time, and the rate constants. And so if we do polymer 3, polymer 4, etc., we can see polymer 3 forms from polymer 2, and it reacts to polymer 4. So it's going to be the same behavior for polymer 2. So for all the J's greater than or equal to 2, concentration, polymer J, rate constant M, polymer 2, it formed from polymer 1, so this is J minus 1, resonance time, and the monomer concentration. And since we can calculate polymer 1 in terms of monomer, we can calculate polymer 2, we can then calculate polymer 3, we can calculate all the polymer concentrations. We can do these calculations in terms of the initiation rate constant, the propagation rate constant, the resonance time, and the monomer concentration in the reactor. That's the first part of solving this problem. In the next video, we'll go through the details of the calculations, how to simplify these mass balances. But here, we've set up the reactions, and we've shown how to do the mass balances for the monomer and for the polymers.